Here are some of the techniques that I'm following to do my macro development in my applications or even libraries. And the trick is to use Cargo Expand with Cargo Watch and then to have the terminal on the right. So let's see how it works. So first here, we need to make sure that we are going to install Cargo Expand. So that is a command, cargo install, cargo expand. So far so good, I already have installed it. Now Cargo Expand to run has to have the nightly install. So what we're going to do here is install the nightly. And we don't have to set this project to use nightly, but nightly has to be installed on the system, such as Cargo Expand can use it. Then once we have that here installed, we are going to do our little example here. So for example, in our case, we have our trait, which is just an example here, model access controller, and that is part of the pattern we want to have in our application. The pattern doesn't really matter here. It's just to show how we can remove boilerplate code with macros. And then if, for example, we want to have a model access controller for to-do entity, we'll have the struct like this. And then we want to have our best practices here where actually the table and the columns of this entity will be const of the struct. And then we just have a constructor this way here, very simple for now. We are going to implement our Mac with something like that. So every time we have to do a new model access controller for an entity, we're going to have to duplicate that. So that is obviously not fully optimized, but it does work. And so for example, here, we could create our new Mac or to-do, and then we can just print the to-do table, for example. Press save, cargo run -q, and then we have our to-do table. So everything works fine, but obviously not very optimized here because every time we have this boilerplate. So let's say that rather to create all of this here, I could say, well, I want to normalize it in my code and I can use a declarative macro. We could do it also with procedural, doesn't really matter. That will look like this. So we have our def mac, the name of the struct, the to-do, and then the ID. And then after I can get rid of all of this once I have that implemented. So we're going to comment it out, press save, everything compiles. Okay, so the way that I like to do it here is I'm going to come back this way. I'm going to make this one pub, and I'm going to move that into its own module, Mac. And that means that now I'm going to do a Mac.rs. I'm going to make that over there. Go back on this guy that we use Mac, Mac trait. Press save. I have everything that compiles. Everything is good. And now what I want is in Mac, I want to define that macro here, such as I don't have to repeat that every time I have a new entity for to-do, for project, for task, or whatever, to repeat this boilerplate code. So the way that I will do that, come back to Mac. I'm going to make sure that I do the macro use here to make sure that all of the macros of this file will be exported for this application. And then I'm going to create my macro, which is going to look like that. And we're going to go with the macro rules, def mac, and that will take three arguments, the entity, which is the struct name, the table name, and the arrays here, static array of the columns. And right now, I'm just going to have pub struct, just to make it simple for now, s this. Now I'm going to press save, and everything should compile. So far, I don't have any warning. Now the trick here is how can I be fast at iterating through my macro here? I actually put the terminal on the right side. And then I'm going to define here, and here's a little trick here. Mod, there's a reason for that. Quick dev. And inside quick dev, I'm going to use super. And this is temporary, yes? It's just for while we are developing, maturing the macro here. And that is a little trick. And now within the quick dev, I can do my macro call here. I'm going to copy that here and I can press save and everything works, but I don't know how it looks like. And that is where cargo expand works. We're going to do a cargo watch dash Q dash C for clear dash X. And then here we're going to do the expand. And in expand, we're going to give our Mac quick dev. And the reason here why we have this quick dev here, little hack, is because this way we don't have other kind of macro and expand and so on. We can just focus on coding our macro live in a way, seeing what is output, and then we can get rid of this module. So I press enter here, and now I have this very nice pub struct here. I see exactly what it output. And so now the only thing I need to do is go back here, and we want also to do this code block here in our macro. And so we're going to add that here. And then obviously here that wouldn't be to do. That is going to be our table name, so $table. And that on the right shouldn't be hard-coded, obviously. It will be our calls. And then the to-do mac here, which is this one, and this one, that should be our S for our struct name. And this one as well, forget it, press save. And boom, we can see live here on the right side. And so now I'm pretty happy with that. I'm going to feel a little bit more confident here and do the implementation of the Mac. Go back here. I'm going to add a new code block here. And I'm going to make sure I have the full path, the trait. And this will be a $S. And everything else should be the same. Press save. Then we have all our things. And again, here, super fast, because you can see what you are doing live without the noise of anything else. Yes, so here, for example, if I want to say, well, I want to see if I do a project Mac here, project, and then press save, and then everything works fine. So nothing has been hard-coded or whatever. And now that I have that, I can go back here, take all of this boilerplate code, remove it, remove this one, press save, everything compile, and then I just quit this one, and I do my cargo, wash dash q dash c dash x, run dash q, and on my system I have aliases here, so obviously I don't have to type that all the time, but I don't want to confuse people here, and then I do this, and then that's it. And if I do something like that, I have should be able to have this here. Press save. Boom. We have that. That's it. So super fast to implement macros. My strategy is often I default to declarative macros at first. And at some point, when things mature in the object model, if things is more appropriate to have it as a procedural macro, as a derive, then I add those as derive. But with this model here, I can really remove a lot of boilerplate code with some kind of neat things. And now we are good, so we can remove this one here. We don't need it. Press save. Everything works. And we are happy. Hope you liked it. Until next one, happy coding.